Championship Wrestling, bringing you great wrestling action sanctioned by the NWA, the National Wrestling Alliance.
Guess what? We have new World Tag Team Champions.
They are the Rock and Roll Express, defeating Rick Rude and the Raging Bull. David, and we're going to take a look at how that happened today.
That's right, we are. And listen to this. We have the great tag teams from all over the world. The Freebirds are here. Also, we're going to get to see the Dream Team, the World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair and Lex Luger.
Including today, we have news about the Great American Bash. Of course, you know, July means the best in wrestling for the NWA and the Great American Bash coming your way. Some news on that also coming here today on this program. David, a great program, but I want to remind the fans that tomorrow night at the Omni in Atlanta, a gigantic card because you talked about the Freebirds. They are coming back home to the Omni in a big six-man tag team event. That's tomorrow night.
That's right. And also, Tony, on this program, we're going to show you some news because it is news all over the world about an injury in wrestling.
And, of course, it concerns a man who has injured people before, and he's done it again. We'll let you ride on that, and we'll go to the ring for action.
The New Breed, Chris Champion and Sean Royal.
Quite a combination, and certainly, David, you think about the contenders for the World Tag Team title held by the Rock and Roll Express. Of course, there are your U.S. Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express, but also consider this team right here, the New Breed.
You definitely have to because they have the strength, the quickness, and the desire to win that championship. Wrong that time.
Alan Martin, not a bad move at all as he tags Mike Force. You got to stay on top of this team. They're so quick. Such endurance by the New Breed that they can take an apparent move of yours and turn it against you, like right there.
Chris Champion now. Kick right behind the head.
You know, we talk about the things they say to us on the interviews and the odd way they conduct themselves on interviews. There's no denying that in the ring, it's all business for them. And they're two great athletes. And Chris Champion has changed his hairstyle a little bit. Have you noticed that? Not much. It's a subtle change, but it's a change.
They are very confident.
Got that checkerboard look on that left side there.
Chop to the chest.
There's that look. Watch out. We've seen this move before.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. How'd you like that, Mr. Crockett?
They have the teamwork.
Awesome. You know you like it.
They are strong.
Champion up on top. Long way to drop onto somebody.
Come on.
Well, I don't think Alan Martin will get up from that unless he's helped up by one of the new breeds. Oh, great slam right there.
Come down on him hard.
I tell you what, they're feeling good.
Yeah, sometimes you think they could be too confident.
Yeah, we've seen so many teams go up against them.
Well, that's a good move there.
Boy, well, a drop kick off of the suplex. So many teams go up against the Rock and Roll Express and be overconfident. There's a lot of confidence in the camp of the new breed. And there they are, champion and royal.
All right, here we go with their winning ways. The new breed.
David and Royal, the new breed, are your winners on World Championship Wrestling. We talked about the Rock and Roll Express New World Tag Team Champions. Of course, for the fourth time in their career, they won the NWA World Tag Team title, defeating Rick Rude and the Raging Bull. David, let's take a look at some footage of that match.
All right, let's go to it right now. Both teams are going 100%
for the World Tag Team title. David, we know the punishment of a guy like the Raging Bull can dish down, but in the same turn, you know how much punishment and how much endurance the Rock and Roll Express has.
Because they had the fans behind them that whole time they've been in there. Gibson trying to make that tag to Ricky. The Bull pulls him back. Good suplex there.
Well, you got to realize this match has been going on of way over 20, 30 minutes right now. Giving it 100% is Paul Jones. A little bit concerned right there in the corner.
Trying to choke him down. Referee Tommy Young now. Caught it.
And here's something we have seen before from the Raging Bull. Notice the hands clamped over the nose and the mouth of Robert Gibson. You've gone a long time, you've wrestled a long time, you're winded. And the Bull now just trying to additionally cut off that supply, David. Bottom of your screen.
Stacy Ricky, he is ready. He's got his win back. Robert's just about over there trying to make it. So close now. Just about there. Ricky's reaching out.
Now, Robert's not sure where he is.
All right, the tag is made. Tommy Young didn't see it, though.
What happened was Rick Rude conveniently got the attention of Tommy Young.
Remember the punishment that Robert Gibson's been taking. Fires away on him. He goes up. See, they want to punish him. They want to beat him down.
Doing just that, but look here. Talking about taking advantage of the situation. A great move by Gibson, and Rude is hurt.
Robert looks over. He catches Ricky. Sees him out of the corner of his eye. Trying to drag himself over. Rolls over. The tag is made. Here comes Ricky. Firing away at the Bull. Backs him in now. Here goes the cross. Catches Rude. Goes right back to Bull. Good backdrop. Takes him over to watch him. Flip. Catches him down. Now all four men in the ring.
This is where the pandemonium begins because you know what we're talking about. The World Tag Team title on the line.
All right, they threw Ricky out now.
Now remember, Ricky Morton, the legal man in the ring, along with the Raging Bull right now. Tommy Young trying to clear the ring.
Ricky catches. Now here he goes, flips over, has him down. Tommy's there for the count, and he did it. And there you have it.
Yes, sir. World Tag Team Champions again.
Rock and roll is here to stay.
We'll talk about the Bash when we come back. World Championship Wrestling, the Civic Arena, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Friday, July 10th at 8 o'clock in Pittsburgh. The Capitol Center, Landover, Maryland. Thursday, July 2nd at 8 o'clock at the Cap Center in Landover. The Civic Center, Amarillo, Texas. Sunday, June 21st, 8 o'clock in Amarillo. It's the Popeye Summer Spectacular at the Summit in Houston, Texas. Saturday, June 20th, the bell time, 8 o'clock at the Summit in Houston. The Leon County Civic Center, Tallahassee, Florida. Friday, June 19th at 8:30 in Tallahassee. Rapide Parish Coliseum, Alexandria, Louisiana. Thursday, June 18th at 7:30 in Alexandria. Cumberland County Memorial Arena in Fayetteville, North Carolina. Tuesday, June 16th at 7:30. That's in Fayetteville. The Civic Center, Tulsa, Oklahoma. Sunday, June 14th, the bell time, 8 o'clock in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Baltimore Arena, Baltimore, Maryland. Saturday, June 13th, the bell time, 8 o'clock in Baltimore. The Civic Center, Lake Charles, Louisiana. Friday, June 12th, the bell time, 7:30 in Lake Charles. The Cincinnati Gardens, Cincinnati, Ohio. Thursday, June 11th, the bell time, 8 o'clock. A super spectacular night of NWA action at the Cincinnati Gardens. Thursday, June 11th, the bell time, 8 o'clock. And the Omni in Atlanta, tomorrow night, the bell time, 8 o'clock. It's a super spectacular night of wrestling tomorrow night, 8 o'clock, at the Omni in Atlanta. It's the NWA, the National Wrestling Alliance. It's the Major League of Professional Wrestling. The NWA is awesome, and fans, as you know, during the summer, the Great American Bash comes your way. And Jim Crockett Promotions, many great events during the course of the year, but during the summer, the event is the Great American Bash, combining the best in music with the best in professional wrestling. And this year, the Great American Bash on Tour kicks off in the Lakeland Civic Center on July 1st. The Great American Bash on Tour also in the Cap Center this year in Landover, Maryland, going to Baltimore, Philadelphia, Dallas, San Francisco, Los Angeles, and many other great places around the country. Also, the best in music, the Freebirds, of course, are part of the Bash, and they'll have their Bad Street Concert Southern Rock and Roll Reunion this year as part of the Great American Bash and many other great events coming up during the summer. Let's bring in Mr. Jim Crockett, the president of Jim Crockett Promotions. I know a lot of great dates coming up, but I know July 4th is on your mind, Jimmy.
Yes, July 4th is a very special day, of course, being the anniversary of this country's birthday. But we have come up with, a promoter's dream, a match that has never taken place before. And you can think of them, but actually signing them is something else. And we have signed for July the 4th, the Match Beyond.
Okay, and next week, fans, more about the Match Beyond and more about the Great American Bash coming your way this July. Let's go to the ring.
Rock and Roll Express.
Quite a duo. Champions again, and the fans love it.
Look at this teamwork. Nice on the
ground. David, the fans here in the studio, WTBS, red hot for NWA Wrestling. And you know, tomorrow night in the Omni, gonna be much the same thing.
Because the Freebirds are coming home to the Omni tomorrow night.
Freebirds, a great tag team, and of course the team on top of the pinnacle right now. Robert and Ricky.
And what about the news about the Great American Bash? You can better way the month of July.
Better believe the Rock and Roll Express will be part of the Great American Bash, not only in the ring, David, but maybe a little musical way, too.
Oh, that's right. Also, think about it. July 4th, the match beyond.
What we're going to do, we'll talk more about it next week. Just let your imagination run for a week. The match beyond. Obviously beyond any other that you've ever seen.
Hard fist to the chest. Nice hip toss. Still keeps that arm. Ricky Morton. Where they're happy. Happy to be the World Tag Team Champion. For the fourth time.
They know as well as any other team in the sport of wrestling, as Teddy Long talks to Ricky Morton about using the arm that time. They know that when you get a title, when you're a world champion, you become the hunted. The chase is still on, but now they're chasing you. Ricky and Rob will be the first two to tell you that they don't mind people chasing them.
That's right. You have people like United States Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express. The team we saw out here just a minute ago, the New Breed.
How about the Dream Team, Ric Flair and Lex Luger? We'll see them a little bit later on.
That's right. In action.
In action. How about Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson, another great tag team member of the Four Horsemen. Oh, great
good
move.
Either. And the quickness, the desire, teamwork. And here it comes.
Double!
Put them down for the three count.
Ricky Morton, Robert Gibson win again, David.
Riding high, the world tag team champions, the Rock and Roll Express. They set him up with a double drop kick and put him down for the pin. Your winners, the world tag team champions, the Rock and Roll Express.
We'll talk to the champions, have much more on our program right after this.
Let's stop BSing the people in this country. Ric Flair, let's stop BSing the people in this country. Lex Luger, Arn Anderson, Jay Dillon, let's stop talking about it.
You might end up with your foot in your mouth. You can't judge an apple by looking at a tree. You can't judge a honey by looking at the bee. You can't judge a dog by looking at the mother. You can't judge it by looking at the brother. Come on, can't you see?
The titles are right here on TV. Ricky and Robert, the Rock and Roll Express.
That's right, Tony. It feels like the fourth time, baby. We told you, Manny Fernandez and Rick Rude. Well, and Paul Jones. Before the summer was over, baby, we're going to be the new NWA World Tag Team Champions. And right here tells you what it's all about, brother. Right here. But don't forget, Tony, we are world champions in what we do. We put these belts in the fit of all the time. No dust is going to collect on them. So tonight in Greensboro, be ready, Ric Flair and Lex Luger, brother. Come and get what you want. Take your best shot back, Jack. But don't you blow it. We are here, NWA World Tag Team Champions. We are here. Thanks to all the people that still behind us, Tony. We're back on top. One more time. Woo!
Okay, congratulations, Robert, Ricky, on winning the belts once again. Let's go back to the ring.
he hops around so much. With a woman like that, Pratchett.
David, before the match gets underway, we have a lot of NWA fans up in Pittsburgh. As always, the NWA Hot in the Civic Arena is coming your way on July 10th. Reminder that tickets will go on sale for that event coming up this Tuesday. They go on sale this Tuesday, and that, of course, will be June 9th for that big event in the Civic Arena.
Watch Gorgeous Jimmy. Drops him right across the ropes. Toss him in the head. Think about this. World heavyweight champion Ric Flair. You want Precious, you've got to go through Gorgeous Jimmy. And he wants your championship.
Yeah, again, Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin.
With pressure. Ooh, Liker in blue. Gorgeous Jimmy picks him up and puts him down hard. Your winner, Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, with pressure.
We'll be right back. And tonight, it's a big night for not only the Tully Blanchard and Dark Journey, James J. Dillon, all the Four Horsemen, because it's winner take all.
Well, you know, just seeing the logo of the Four Horsemen across the ring and across the TV screen is just, it just inspires me that much more. And right now, let's face it, all the talking is done. The $100,000 is on the line. Winner take all, of course, I'm talking about tonight in Greensboro. And Mr. Blanchard, frankly, I expected the American Dream to be here live today, really out here sucking and jiving and trying to befuddle us as best he could. But again, the unexpected. I don't know if he's drawn his seclusion, if he's taking Magnum PA with him or what, but one thing I know for sure, you are prepared.
You know, J.J. Dillon, it's a beautiful day outside. Been one all day all over the country. It's June the 6th, the day everybody's been talking about. DJ's looking fine today. J.J.'s looking fine. You feel good, Tony Giovanni?
I feel great, Tony.
You're looking good. You're doing a great job today. And I feel great. Flair and Lex feel great. Arn feels great. The Horsemen are alive and well and really exciting. And you know, when that limousine pulls in to Greensboro Coliseum tonight and drops off the Horseman, DJ looking only the way she can look, and all the people are going to be thinking about Magnum TA bringing that $50,000 of that common people money down. J.J. Dillon with that check that he's going to give the DJ to carry. And that's what it's all about. Winner take all, $100,000. Most people only dream about having 100 grand in a bank at one point in their life. And it all comes down to 60 minutes. Dusty Rhodes, you and me, I don't care if you're in seclusion or where you are, because baby, my bio rhythms are up. I'm excited. June the 6th is the day that I take all the money. All your pride, Dusty Rhodes, all your bragging rights, anything you've got to say in professional wrestling is going to be over with after tonight in the Greensboro Coliseum, because Big Dust, you can't come out here and talk about being the biggest sports attraction, the greatest star of them all, when you go down 1-2-3, and that's the bottom line, because the man that walks out with this a few hours from now is going to have all the glory, all the prestige, all the notoriety, all anything in the world you would want, and that's just what it is. That's why I wanted the Four Horsemen. That's the symbol.
Tully Blanchard and Doc Journey right here on World Championship Wrestling. And don't forget tonight, hit for $100,000, winner take all in Greensboro, Jim Cornette.
Let me just say this real short and sweet. Ladies and gentlemen, the most awesome, powerful force on the face of the planet Earth, the U.S. Tag Team Champions, Beautiful Bobby and Sweet Stan, the Midnight Express.
United States Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express, Sweet Stan Lane, and Beautiful Bobby, along with Jim Cornette.
How you guys doing today, huh? You feel all right?
We feel good,
but you probably look better than
we feel great, Jimmy, and of course, I must say, you look great.
I feel great. You know something right there? In action in the ring, you see the Midnight Express, and these men right here, I was just thinking about today, are examples of what American youth should look up to. Look at the teamwork, brother. They are fantastic. Every move is synchronized. They know exactly what they're doing, and more importantly, they present a good image. They're not out here like the Rock and Roll Express. Got long, straggly...
That's right. They're not World Tag Team Champions.
They're not out here like... Shut up, Tony. I'll get to that. They're not out here like the Rock and Roll Express. Long, straggly, blonde hair, bandanas tied all around them. Look like an explosion, a Salvation Army drop box. They and myself are dignified men. They are out here presenting a good image for the American youth to look up to want to grow up to be like. Honesty, integrity, sportsmanship, just like me, just like the Midnight Express. Who in the world in their right mind would want their kids to grow up like the Rock and Roll Express, huh? A couple of juvenile delinquents, a couple of frustrated juvenile delinquents because they can't beat the Midnight Express. That's exactly what they are. Look at Ronnie Garvin. What self-respecting parent would want their kid to grow up like Ronnie Garvin? Looks like he just escaped out of a Boris Karloff movie. He walked past a cemetery last week. Two guys ran after him with shovels. Are you kidding?
I guess you're saying that parents out there would want their kids to grow up like Bobby Eaton, right?
That's exactly right. What I'm saying is that people all over the country right now have champions they can be proud of. U.S. Tag Team Champions, beautiful Bobby and Sweet Stan, two fine athletes, two Christian athletes that all the kids in the world should look up to, want to grow up like, want to be like. And then there's me. Then there's me, you see.
There's you.
All the kids all over the country, their parents should want them to grow up like me. A man devoted to his mother. Do you want to say something to your mother at home watching you on national TV, huh? Huh? Go ahead and say something, boy. Take a look. Belts here, man.
Yeah, I want my kid to be just like that.
We wanted to let that guy say something to his mother on national television, and I wanted to show him the United States Tag Team title belt, and he did, and we did. That's exactly right. Wait a minute.
Hey, hands him down.
Hey, this guy's trying to win the match. That ain't fair, man. Hold on.
At least it got Cornette over the corner, David. We can't deny how great this team is. You know how good they are.
We can't have nobody trying to make us look bad now. Now, like I was saying, you got me, a man devoted to his mother. A man who dresses probably better than anybody in the world today. A guy who's good-looking, who's clean-cut, who's successful, who's wealthy, who's intelligent, who's well-spoken, who's modest. Every parent in the country would want their kids to grow up like me. So in short, you got to it. Look at this move right here. What teamwork, man. Woo! That's the chiropractor crunch right there. We just gave that boy a little adjustment. So in short, what you got is two great athletes, two fine champions. You got me, who's probably one of the most upstanding, honest, fair, sportsman-like people in the country today. And look
here
at
goes
beautiful Bobby. Nobody in the world does stuff like he does it, baby. Yee-haw!
You have look to at, agree with Cornette on that one.
Look at Darren Stevens right there. Darren Stevens, he's a real good guy. Get him out of there. Here comes Trent Knight. Good night, Trent Knight, in a minute. Now, I'm just going to say this like I said. Everybody would want their kids to grow up like me in the Midnight Express. But I'm going to say something to that stupid, stinking Rock and Roll Express, those punks. What they better do is they better shine them belts up real good. And they better get used to wearing them, because pretty soon, if they got the guts to get in the ring against these men, they ain't going to be wearing them. I'm sick of the Rock and Roll Express. I'm sick of that crummy, no-good Ronnie Garvin trying to assassinate me. Woo! And that's good night. Good night, Trent Knight.
Good night it is. He ties him up, puts him down for the pin. Sweet Stan Lane. Beautiful Bobby. The Midnight Express. Look at this. Watch him. He's going to drop him right on his face. Straight into the mat. And then down for the pin. Your winners, the United States Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express.
All right, boy, gonna look like you've been chasing parked cars around here. Look, Tony, we want you to know what it's like to be a champion for once in your life, because you're never going to get rewarded any other way around here. Now, let me say this, like I said, my man, Sweet Stan, who knows a lot of celebrities, who's been meeting, having personal appearances with a lot of celebrities lately. Beautiful Bobby, the Midnight Express, U.S. Tag Team Champions, Rock and Roll Express. What you are is a couple of dingbats. You're a couple of nappy-headed punks. You're a couple of pieces of scum of the earth. That's exactly what you are, and I'm going to come out here. here, and I'm going to defame your character, and I'm going to do whatever necessary, just like I did the last time. You remember Tony Schiavone, they won the World Tag Team title, and we chased them, and we chased them, and we chased them, and we called them every dirty, stinking kind of yellow coward in the book, and finally, they agreed to face us. Well, this time, rock and roll, you got the titles back. The ones that we took from you before, we're going to do the same thing. Great American Bash on tour coming up in the month of July. I can't think of a better time. Put those belts up, rock and roll. Do anything else you want to do with them, but put them up against the Midnight Express when you're ready to lose them. Because believe me, that's what's going to happen. We're going to teach you what it's like to be a rock and not to roll. Because we're going to give the heart of rock and roll a triple bypass, brother.
Fans, we'll be right back. Don't go away.
Please sit down and take a look at what's really causing all this. The World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. Because it's the best going today. Woo!
Going after one man in particular, Big Bubba, but I also know in Houston, Barry, it's a big tournament you're going to be involved.
Right. You know, in Houston, there's a big tournament for the Western Championship. You know, it's a heavyweight championship, and it's a stepping stone to the World Heavyweight Championship. It's not necessarily a new title, but it's been one that's been left on the shelf for a while. But I tell you what, that championship is one that a lot of men are gunning for, a lot of top stars in wrestling today, and I intend to be one of the ones right up there at the top of the heap, and I'm going to come out with that championship. Now, something else I want to talk about, Bubba Rogers, right here in the Omni tomorrow night. The championship that he has is something that I want. Bubba Rogers, you and I are going to go for it, big boy. And I tell you what, it's going to be one fight you're not going to forget for a long time.
Okay, Barry Windham, and Barry, good luck getting that Western States Heritage title in the Summit in Houston. Fandles, go back to the ring.
In the ring, Double A, Arn Anderson. Taking on Chance McQuay. Double A, one of the four horsemen. And he could be the most sadistic of the four.
David, we would like to welcome Hall of Famer Lou Brock ringside right here at World Championship Wrestling. Understand he has three sons, one drafted by the San Diego Chargers of the NFL, one watches this program all the time. Lou Brock here with us, and we're very happy to have Lou Brock, the greatest base stealer of all time, no doubt about it.
That is true. And his son's watching the best. World Championship Wrestling, WTBS. Look at Arn. Take that arm and drive it up. Just content right now to punish the man. All right, here he goes. This is a typical patented Anderson move. Slam him on the arm. Drive the knee into the shoulder. Now start to twist.
Member of the Four Horsemen, the Elite. A lot of challenge out to the Four Horsemen. And one of those challengers, of course, the threesome of the Three Birds. The Three Birds will be at the Omni tomorrow night. And that should be a great six-man event, David.
That is true. And tonight, another horseman has a challenge by the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. You heard Tully Blanchard, World Television Champion out here. $100,000 at stake. Here he goes across. You heard him? Then watch it, Freeberg.
Gourd Buster. No. Now. Double A, Iron Anderson, one of the four horsemen. You watch him now. The Gourd Buster puts him down for the pin. All right, we talked about the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and the match with Tully Blanchard for the World Television title. Let's go to an interview with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, right now.
Dusty Rhodes, I know the Great American Bash brings back memories for you that night in Greensboro winning the world title once again.
What is the hottest time of the year? I feel so good in that. Out here right before we come on, I found these book of matches in Tony's coat here, say, the Hemsley Palace in New York City. We know about that night. Dusty Rhodes feels so good. Tully Blanchard belongs to me. The money belongs to me. Maggie taking care of business with the money. Let me tell you something, baby. Let me tell you something good. You know, on a Friday night, let's say the Hemsley Palace. Let's say the place where the Nature Boy hangs out. Let's say the limousines, you know what I mean? Always late on a Friday night, I get just a little bit whiskey bit and glory bound, you know what I mean? And I start thinking about the Great American Bash. Dusty Rhodes being World Heavyweight Champ for the third time. I start feeling good because Friday night is the night of heroes. And Saturday night, I am the champion of legendary Saturday night. So let the good times roll. Rock and Roll Express, full-time World Tag Team Champion. Make me feel good inside. Make me want to dance, twist and shout, and do a double backflip. I'm beside myself. And when I'm beside myself, that's about 600 pounds. 3-3, you understand? So Tully Blanchard, you got me in a good mood tonight. And Doc Journey asked Tully Blanchard, the last woman that he had with him, what happened to her, you understand? After making a lady out of her like I did. You know what I mean, Doc Journey? Woo, I love brown sugar too, baby.
Precious, and another great win right here on television.
Tony, I gotta tell you, we got some friends at the Hemsley Palace in New York City, Daddy, and you're over there, let me tell you that. Now, the fact is this, ladies and gentlemen, it's just around the corner, all right! You can feel it in the air, man. There's excitement in the air. There's electricity in the air. We got Bash on Tour coming up. The month of July is gonna be wild. Squeeze and I are the happiest couple in the world today. We just gotta be, because we got Ric Flair where we want him, don't we, Squeeze? I still got this pretty woman under my arm, and I just about got your title, Ric Flair. You're just like a wounded animal, Pally. It's just a matter of time. I was worried at first, Tony, about the other three horsemen always hanging around. But hey, when you've got friends like the American Dream and my brother Ronnie Garvin, Hands of Stone, and Barry Windham, and the Rock and Roll Express, which I'd like to congratulate on winning for the fourth time, Tony, the World Tag Team titles. And I gotta tell you, folks, don't make a mistake. Get up right now, go to your calendar, mark your circle there, because Bash on Tour in July, you're not gonna wanna miss it. It don't matter what city it's in, it's gonna be a good time. And Ric Flair, I'm gonna take your title. We got him where we want him, Tony. Lex Luger can't sleep because he can't beat Nikita. And Ric Flair, you sick pervert, you Pally, you don't have a chance.
Gorgeous Jimmy and Precious, let's go to the ring, fans. Thank you.
from Bad Street, USA. Terry Gordy, Michael Hayes, Buddy Roberts, the Freebirds against Thunderfoot 1 and 2 and one of the Gladiators. Michael Hayes watches Bam Bam in the ring. Think they're not ready for the Horsemen?
That's right.
Think the
tomorrow night at the Omni.
And you think the fans aren't ready for the Freebirds to come back home? Oh, what a night it's going to be tomorrow night.
Look at Bam Bam.
Come on! Thunderfoot number one wants to tag somebody, and I guess Gladiator number one says okay.
That was a mistake.
Buddy Roberts. Says Gladiator. Rams his head in that turnbuckle. The Fabulous Freebird. Running drop kick. And here comes Bam Bam again. Ooh, nice.
Great move right there. Gordy and Roberts, the Freebirds. The Thunderfoot tries to get a punch in. Fans will have more on World Championship Wrestling right after this timeout.
Dropping foot on his head.
Michael Hayes enters the ring. Takes Thunderfoot. Drops him again. What are they going to do now? Bam Bam picks him up. The tag has already been made.
Oh!
Your winners, the Fabulous Freebirds. Terry Gordy, the tag's already been made. Michael Hayes drops right across the head and puts him down for the pin. Your winners, the Freebirds.
Bringing Terry, Michael, and Buddy right now. Tomorrow night, the Omni, the countdown is on for the Four Horsemen and the Freebirds to collide.
You know something? Now, if I ain't mistaken, being a country boy, I remember that horses have four legs. Ain't that right?
That's right.
Well, let me let you know something, baby. Ain't nothing with four wheels we can't drive. Ain't nothing with four legs we can't ride. And tomorrow night, the Omni, you go out to ride down Bad Street. You understand what I'm talking about? Because Ric Flair's out here, and Ric Flair says, whoa, we can get down. Hey, baby, anybody can get down. It's those of us that can get back up. And we're going to stay up all night tonight, bringing out that bottle of blackjack, waiting for the return home in the Omni.
That's right, you know. When I see the horsemen out here, they remind me of flies, and they look like they just come from a pile of you-know-what. Now, you know, it's like this. They get out here, and they talk about that they got all the money. They got all the women. Well, let me tell you something. I don't drive a big fine car, and I ain't got a whole lot of money, but I got two fists and I got 2 feet that says they're gonna kick your butt.
Hey, you know what? Hey, you heard that saying? Sticks and stones will break our bones, but names don't ever hurt us. Well, we don't usually care about that. Hey, but the horsemen, Ric Flair, J.J. Dillon, even talking about the birds on national TV, Channel 17, Super Stage. Hey, we're back to show you what the birds are about. You remember that movie by Hitchcock, The Birds? It was a horrifying movie. Well, we too can be horrified when we watch.
That's right, buddy. So you remember it. We're going to be up all night drinking that blackjack thinking about you. You won't be able to sleep at all thinking about the Omni. Let's go back to the ring.
Let him in, Pietro.
Managed by Paul Jones. That's right. Paul Jones. David, obviously Paul Jones very distraught because of what had happened to the World Tag Team belts.
And I think the Four Horsemen are going to be sort of destroyed tomorrow night.
I think so, too. Oh, boy. You can just feel the electricity when the Freebirds walk out here, so you know how it's going to be tomorrow night in the Omni.
Hey.
Well,
now for the pin.
So much for that. Look at Paul Jones.
Add a little extra there.
Vladimir Petrov. David, he is one awesome individual, and he gets better and better each week.
Watch this. The Russian Sikhar. Vladimir Petrov.
And down for the pin.
This young man is fired up for that tournament.
Fired up for the tournament for the Western States Heritage title at the Summit in Houston. And also fired up because tomorrow night, Skandar Akbar brings in Big Bubba. Barry Windham aims to chop him down. Your winner, Barry Windham. And here is the U.S. Heavyweight Champion. You hear the chance for Nikita, and I know he's still thinking about Lex Luger.
I want to say one thing first to Dick Murdoch. Tomorrow night, right here in Atlanta, Dick Murdoch, I have something to pay you back. Now, Lex Luger, he's a big, big man, Tony, Lex Luger. Well, everybody know how big you are, Lex Luger. But a lot of people want to know just how bad is Lex Luger. Well, about a week ago, I find out that you, Lex Luger, you are bad. If you are with Ric Flair, you are bad. If you have Tony Blanchard by your side, you are bad, Lex Luger. But by yourself, you're not so bad. Ric Flair, by yourself, you're not so bad. Tony Blanchard, 1-1, he's not so bad. So I tell it to you like this, Lex Luger. You see the title right here. USA champion. Lex Luger, if you want to defeat me and be USA champion, you make sure they have to carry me from the ring to the top.
Kita Kolov, the U.S. champion, let's go back to the ring.
In the ring now, Hands of Stone, Ron Garvin. Watch this man. Hands of stone. When this man's in the ring, he is all bent.
Good night, Irene.
The gun's loaded.
He picked him up.
He's gonna do it again. Why not?
He was out on his feet when he picked him up also. Like when you have a birthday, they give you one to grow on. That one was one to lay down on.
Guns are blazing. Push him out. And down. Your winner, Hands of Stone, Rod Garvin.
You can tell.
The man got up, didn't know where he was. I figured
he was out on his feet.
Finish him off.
I know. You guys are ready, I know, to get those U.S. tag team titles.
That's right. You know, the Midnight Express, you're no better. You're sculling any harder than these guys. You've been down before for the count. And believe me, Barry Windham and I, we're ready for you guys. Now, you might think you're going to be undefeated, that you're going to keep these belts forever. Well, you stole them from us, and we're coming back to get them, and we mean it.
You know what we've done, Tony? We turned over a new leaf. You know, Jim Cornette always interferes in these matches. So what we're going to do is get rid of Jim Cornette before anything takes place in a match. So, Mr. Cornette, you can consider it a promise. You can bank on it. When we come into a match for those United States Tag Team Championships, you're going to be fit to be tied.
Barry Windham and Ron Garvin and fans, when we come back, Dick Murdoch strikes again. And we'll tell you about it right after this.
is that this is totally uncalled for. There's no, there can be no reasoning for it.
And there it happened, David.
That's right. They broke his arm, Eddie Gilbert and Dick Murdoch. What reason? You have to ask Dick
well,
Murdoch.
Well, those things happen in professional wrestling, you know, and I tell you what, there's no reason for that. There's no reason for that. However, let's bring in James J. Dillon along with Lex Luger, who will tell you that things like that happen in professional wrestling because this is a man's sport.
Well, I don't know if it's hot in here today or what. I think I've got a real serious case of bash fever. That's right. It's right around the corner. A lot of exciting thing happened. $1 million challenge, $100,000 challenge tonight. The Freebirds and the Omni tomorrow, but we're looking towards that bash. You know, last year, the bash, everybody said Ronnie Garvin was going to knock Blanchard out all across this country. It didn't happen. There's something special about the bash for the Four Horsemen.
You know, Jacob, you filled me in. I know you've taken care of all our travel arrangements for the summer bash of 87. It's nothing but first-class style because the Four Horsemen... That's the only way they travel, and this is the symbol of excellence, the finest group of athletes in professional sports today. And I am revved up, and Lex Luger is ready to strut his stuff for the summer bash of 87. Nikita Koloff, I'm talking to you right now, and I'm looking you in the eye. The summer bash, before it's all said and done, I will be the U.S. heavyweight champion. We've been knocking on your door for a long time, Nikita, but you wouldn't answer. We finally got you to answer the front door. Next time we come a knocking, me and JJ, we're gonna kick that front door down and take what belongs to Lex Luger. It's in my destiny to be the next U.S. heavyweight champion. You know, JJ, every week I come out here and I stand behind this desk and block. Come here, Tony, and I block. Let's get a full-length shot. JJ, what's the thing? What's causing all this right here?
Yeah.
What it is the greatest code of genetics ever put together. When the big man upstairs says, I'm going to make me a masterpiece, he broke the mold with Lex Luger. Because you see, Lex Luger is a man that is going to take everything. Nikita Koloff, you are part of chapter one of the unprecedented career of the total package, Lex Luger. Someday... You will thank me for even being in the ring with Lex Luger after I take your title, because you'll be able to tell your grandchildren, I wrestled the legendary Lex Luger. The total package is what we're talking about, and what we're looking at right here is real. The greatest physical specimen in sports today, the total package, Lex Luger, Four Horsemen. Check it out. There's nothing like it, baby, anywhere.
We'll be right back, fans. Don't go away.
We're back with the Dream Team, the World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair, and the total package, Lex Luger.
And it's quite an honor always to see the world champion in action right here on World Championship Wrestling. And you're talking about a great team. Hey, this team of Lex Luger and Ric Flair, a super team, the team of Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson. They can team up any way at all. The Horsemen, as we always say, and it's right, they dominate this.
That's right. They rule wrestling. Along with their leader, the world heavyweight champion, Ric Flair. And the management skills of J.J. Dillon. Teamwork, they've got it. Strength, they have it. Skill.
Oh, and the Rock and Roll Express need to take heed because you know the Horsemen will be coming after those belts. We're talking about Flair, Luger, or Blanchard, or Anderson.
How do you defend against these men? You look at the Freebirds, Dusty Rhodes, Nikita Koloff.
Well, it's obvious you can't wrestle on the defensive. You got to go right at them. That's your only chance.
Knee right into the head. You can hear Arn Anderson. And this is saying, beautiful champ.
Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard.
Figure four, he's got it locked.
Dark Journey, they're all out here. James J. Dillon, and there are the horsemen.
There you see them. The four horsemen. Dark Journey, J.J. Dillon.
We are here at ringside.
They have their own fans. The following of the four horsemen. You watch the world heavyweight champion execute moves that has made him famous. The figure four, he locks it, and he has the win. Your winners, the dream team of Lex Luger and Ric Flair. Let's go to Tony.
Please get a shot of it all. Tommy, get a shot of Oliver, baby.
And there it is, and here they are all together.
Tony Giovanni, as you just saw the symbol of excellence, David Craigen asked a very important question. He said, how do you stop what's going on? The Freebirds right here earlier, did you see the teamwork, the quality teamwork of these two men? The Freebirds offer nothing in comparison. You're talking about Bad Street USA. Well, my friend, this is where the Four Horsemen reign. You come from out of town, you're talking about Bad Street. My friend, you look around, you see nothing but champions. The Freebirds, tomorrow night in the Omni, you're coming in our backyard, and there's an old saying, you don't mess with family, which is us, and you don't jump a dog in his own backyard.
Hey, Michael Hayes, go ahead, tell them.
You know what? They come down and walk that aisle, I'm ready to play when they play that music. We're climbing the ring, and the music's all over us. We got to wrestle, and what you're wrestling is the greatest group of athletes
in the sport today.
We're talking about the four horsemen. You picked the wrong group to make a reputation for yourself in Atlanta. Your homecoming is going to be a very startable.
Well, what we got here are the Fruit Birds. That's right, the three Fruit Birds. Ask around, Michael Hayes. You better bring your guitar, bring the mortgage to your car, the mortgage to your house, because after tomorrow night,
remember, Michael Hayes is going to be drinking Jack Daniels all night long. Well, I got news for you, boys. We're going to be drinking Dom Perignon with all the fine women. We're going to be really relaxed and really fine-tuned, because when we walk the aisle in the Omni, that's when all hell breaks loose. Go ask Dusty Rhodes. Go ask Ronnie Garvin, the Rock and Roll Express. Go ask anybody that's best with the Four Horsemen. And you ask them how bad they've been hurt. Jerry Gordy, you got that bandage, buddy. You're going to be hobbling out of the Omni.
Hey, Tony Giovanni, ask Doc Journey what kind of a man Michael Hayes is. Woo! Michael Sheridan told me. Tell Doc Journey. The Birds, I got the JJ with
we know where Bad Street is. Bad Street is right here where the Horsemen walk is where Bad Street is. And we're going to show all of Atlanta in the Omni tomorrow night. Let's stack them up right.